University in the city of New York has been known for years as one of the nation's top colleges. Since being founded in 1754, Columbia has enjoyed a long history as a school of great academic excellence and opportunities. In addition, its location in New York, possibly the world's most exhilarating city, offers even more opportunity for enrichment in many areas. For years, however, Columbia University football did not enjoy the same reputation for excellence. After a Rose Bowl victory in 1934 and the outstanding team to the late 40s, Columbia's football fortunes faded. Then, in 1968, a new head coach, Frank Navarro, came to New York after an outstanding record at Williams. Thanks to the efforts of Navarro and his staff, the football picture brightened. They brought in many outstanding student athletes who helped build Columbia back into a winning team and an Ivy League championship contender. Things look much better at Baker Field, seen here where Columbia University plays its home games. With a strong defense and an explosive offense, Columbia was once again in a position to show well against strong Ivy League competition. Let's now look at some of the highlights from the 1972 season, with particular attention to the players who became the strength of the Lions. For the first time in its long football history, Columbia had a trio of its outstanding stars as captains. From left to right, number 45, Jesse Parks, a wide receiver, number 10, Don Jackson, a quarterback, number 61, Paul Caliades, a linebacker, meet at midfield before the homecoming game against Harvard. All three of these players had been all Ivy selections as juniors back in 1971. The Columbia administration shows its support as Athletic Director Ken Gurman greets the squad at the sidelines before the huddle. The Lion quarterback is number 10, Don Jackson, a good runner as you see here and as you'll see later, an outstanding passer. Jackson from Stuyvesant High School in New York threw for over 1,100 yards in each of his three varsity seasons and threw for 26 career touchdowns. Don came back from knee operations in each of the two last off seasons. Several times he threw for over 230 yards in a game. Jackson was an all-Ivy choice as a junior. He's third on the all-time quarterback list at Columbia. There's Jackson with Coach Frank Navarro. Don ranks behind just Marty Domrace, now with the Baltimore Colts, and Archie Roberts on the all-time passing yardage at Columbia. He also continues in the university's top quarterback tradition. Backup man is number 17, Paul Marino. Marino, a junior from Teaneck, New Jersey, shows ability as a runner as well as a passer. A brilliant wide receiver is number 45, Jesse Parks. Parks from Classical High School in Springfield, Massachusetts, has great hands, good moves, and good speed. Jesse led the league in receiving as a sophomore. He was all-Ivy as a sophomore and junior. He set an all-time career record at Columbia for receiving yardage. He also tied Columbia's career mark for touchdown catches. In addition, this season, Parks set Ivy League records. He became the Ivy League's all-time career yardage receiver, as well as leading the Ivy League career-wise again in reception. outstanding sophomore added to the Columbia receiving corps this year is number 85, Mike Telep. Telep is 6'4", 225 pounds from Byzantine High School in Parma, Ohio. He became an instant starter and an instant star at tight end for the Lions this season. Thanks to performances like these, Telep became the only sophomore named to the AP All-Ivy team. He's already being billed by many as a pro prospect. Fine runner at the slot back position is number 24, Tom Hurley, from Don Bosco High School in Oakland, New Jersey. Hurley, a good runner and a good pass receiver, always able to run after catching the ball. Sophomore Glenn Smith, number 43, moved into the wing back spot as the season went along. Smith from Santa Clara, California, that's just a sophomore, came along well once given the starting role. Still another of the wingbacks is number 32, Rich Manfredi from Hackensack, New Jersey. Manfredi scoring a touchdown here shows the great depth that Columbia had in the offensive backfield. The Lions' leading runner, number 26, George Georges, just a junior. He's from Lowell, Massachusetts. He attended Moses Brown School in Providence, Rhode Island. Georges was the Lions' leading runner. He was sixth in the Ivy League in rushing and has a chance to become Columbia's all-time top runner, a power runner, a workhorse. He also has the ability to catch the ball, also the ability to pick his holes and to make his cuts. And runs like this must have made backfield coach Dan Rort very happy. Another of the fine Lion tailbacks, number 42, Vic Lugo from Clinton High School in Clinton, Massachusetts. He was used extensively as a receiver coming out of the backfield. As you can see, he can also run with the ball. Now Lugo again for a long game against the Crimson of Harvard. Number 36 is Rick Asaph, the Columbia fullback. As you can see, a good runner, also known as one of the top blockers around. He's from St. John's Prep in St. Albans, New York. Watch the blocking next of Harry Bodnar, number 38, leading the hole. As Glenn Smith goes outside, Bodnar noted for his blocking. There he blocks for Don Jackson in a pass play. Bodnar, a sophomore from Pennsylvania, stepped into the starting lineup as the season progressed. Another fullback, number 46, Bill Irish, played high school ball with Don Jackson at Stuyvesant High School. The offensive line, outstanding blocking, allowing that pass play to be complete. Now watch as Terry Smith and Ed Dunn blow them out. Now Terry Smith and center George Rodriguez open a big hole for George Georges. On this play, it's number 79, Herb Baker of Zanesville, Ohio. Line coach Tom Bresnahan, also the offensive coordinator, must have been pleased by runs and holes opened in plays like this. Here it'll be Vincent Wilson, number 77, from Los Angeles, California, with the block in front of the screen. Players participated in the Lion offensive line this season. The centers were Gene Sharon of East Hartford, Connecticut, George Rodriguez, just a sophomore who came on strong from Arlington, Virginia. Tackles included Ed Dunn, a senior and a three-year starter with Columbia. He's from Springfield, Massachusetts. Ed Michael from Cardinal Hayes High School in the Bronx. Herb Baker from Zanesville, Ohio. And Vincent Wilson from Los Angeles High School in Los Angeles. The guards included number 75, Terry Smith, Smith started each of the games in his 3 years as a varsity player for Columbia. He earned AP All-Ivy recognition as a senior, as well as made the AP Honorable Mention All-American team this season. He's from Newport Catholic High School in Alexandria, Kentucky. Also Jim Callanan of Brighton, Massachusetts, and Dez Smith of Brooklyn Tech High School in New York saw considerable action on the offensive line. The Lion offense, an explosive unit at times. You see that they could run and they could throw with some outstanding performers and some great strength. Turned in one of the strongest performances throughout the season. The Columbia defense shut out three opponents during the course of the 72 campaign. They held four of their opponents without scoring a touchdown. Columbia led the Ivy League in scoring defense. They led it in pass defense, and they ranked high nationally throughout much of the season in both of these categories. One of the major reasons was number 21, Ted Gregory. Here you see Gregory with the interception. He's a defensive back from Middletown High School in Middletown, Ohio. Just a junior, he'll be the captain of the 73 Columbia football team. Gregory was all Ivy this past season. He also was the interception leader in the Ivy League as a sophomore in 1971. Here you see he also can return the kick. That punt return going for a touchdown. Now watch this hit. You'll next see a play by Pat Sharkey, number 28. He forces the fumble in this play. Sharkey from Dayton Chaminade High School saw considerable action throughout his 3 years as a Columbia varsity player. Now Sharkey with the interception, showing some of the hustle and determination that made him an outstanding player the past season. Sanchi, number 37. Did an admirable job at the monster back spot from Cheney High School in Youngstown, Ohio. Another defensive back is Kevin Ward, number 25. Ward from Leonia, New Jersey. Hard hitter as he's showing in these plays. Finally, there's Glenn Erickson, number 12, from Everett, Massachusetts. He's the team's leader in interceptions. Also the team's leading punt returner. Defensive backfield coach Tim Gannon had quite a bit of depth to work with. And some pleasing results. Here's Erickson again. Possibly the heart of any defense is at the middle linebacker spot, and there Columbia had one of the best in number 61, Paul Caliades. Here talking with Norm Gerber, the Lions defensive coordinator, and head coach Frank Navarro. Caliades, one of the tri-captains this season from Snyder High School in Jersey City, New Jersey. Won recognition in many areas throughout his career, all Ivy, all East, honorable mention All-American. He was the Ivy League's leading interceptor back in 1971, where he was a co-leader with the team. There's Caliades with the interception. Alongside Caliades was number 58, Max McKenzie, who came into his own the past two seasons from Rice High School in Burlington, Vermont. He, too, earned AP All-Ivy recognition during the 72 campaign. The third senior in that linebacking trio is number 51, Frank Dermody, who makes the hit here. Dermody from Clark Summit, Pennsylvania. Dermody's hit forced the fumble. Standing reserves are Kevin Creedon, number 47, forcing the safety. And Paul Mondor, Creedon from Levittown, Pennsylvania, Mondor from Rhode Island. Mondor, number 44, makes the tackle on this kickoff return. He and Creedon were tough in the kickoff return unit and should see plenty of action in the future. Here's the defensive line in action, led by Mike Evans, number 88. Evans from Classical High School in Springfield, Massachusetts, same as Jesse Parks. He's a junior. He'll be another of the co-captains next season. He earned all Ivy and all East recognition as a sophomore. Number 86, John Leondis of Brooklyn, a senior who saw considerable action in his 3 years in the Columbia light blue. Here Leondis stops the screen. The depth is on the defensive line too. Larry Bryan, number 84, a third defensive end. Bryan, just a junior from Fort Lee, Virginia. Makes the stop again. Now watch this play by John Curtis. Hits the quarterback, number 72, defensive tackle. Now comes back to make the tackle. Brilliant defensive play. Curtis from Danvers, Massachusetts. Another pro prospect from this Columbia team. On this play, Curtis centered on the punt, and number 72 is down to make the tackle and force the fumble. Columbia recovers. Another of Coach Gary Witten's defensive linemen is number 78, Gary Arbesnik from St. Ignatius High School in Cleveland. Saw considerable action, a starter this past season. John Harding, number 30, another senior. And finally, a promising sophomore, number 71, Steve Noble. Noble showed well throughout the season. He's from Kolb High School in Bridgeport, Connecticut. There's Noble again in the Cornell backfield. Before the Lions' final game of the 1972 season, the 20-some seniors who gave 3 years to Columbia football met at midfield. It was Columbia against Brown University at Baker Field. Linebacker Paul Calliades also did the place kicking and the kickoff for Columbia. And the final game is underway. Columbia fans enjoyed many a Don Jackson to Jesse Parks touchdown aerial. And here's the final one of their brilliant varsity careers. Columbia takes the lead against Brown. Mixes it up with a run. The big story of the day was the running of this man, number 26, George Georges, a junior. Rushed for over 190 yards, tearing apart the Brown defense. This was the biggest day by a Columbia runner since back in 1968. Jackson keeps the pressure on with the pass. Georges to the five. And Georges for the touchdown. The outstanding sophomore, Mike Tellup. And now that man, Georges, again. The Columbia Reserves had a chance to show what they can do, and they immediately began moving the ball. Here's a pass from Paul Marino to Bob Wazovich of Brooklyn, Ohio. Brother of a former Columbia great, Bill Wazovich. And now Jeff Cummings of Syracuse, New York, throws to Barry Sorrells of Dallas, Texas for the touchdown. The Lions close the season with a victory over Brown. And you've seen here the strength of the Lions. And with a large contingent of returning lettermen and some good material coming from the freshman squad, Columbia should again next year be a strong contender.